My name is Rebecca Lochmann. I'm a professor of aquaculture and fish nutrition at the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff. And this is the S.J. Parker Agriculture Research Center. And we have a variety of research facilities on this campus, including a variety of tanks, different sizes, and we also have more than 100 research ponds. We conduct research on fish nutrition to help the aquaculture industry. And basically, when you have fish in a culture situation, you have to feed them what they need, exactly what they need to meet all their nutritional needs. But we buy all the ingredients like you would to make a recipe, make cookies in your kitchen or something. We buy ingredients from feed stores and from scientific supply companies, and we mix them together here. We make our own recipes, and we can actually produce a pelleted feed here in our lab. And then we can analyze like the protein, the fat, and all the other components and make sure it has the ingredients we want in there. And then we take fish and we stock them into tanks and we feed them like a certain amount every day for a certain period, maybe 12 weeks. And then we weigh the fish at the end, and we the ones that grew the best, that's the most basic indicator that they were on the best diets. Soybeans have always been a major part of commercial catfish diets, actually. As much as 50% or even up to 60% of traditional catfish diets have been soybean meal. It's one of the best balanced plant protein sources. And of course, soybeans are one of the most abundant crops on earth, so that's good. They're everywhere, and we have a lot in Arkansas as well, so that's a good thing to put in the fish diets. Our research here with fish nutrition is designed partly to improve the nutritional quality of farmed catfish. Some of them have gotten a bad reputation for being low in healthy fatty acids like omega-3 fatty acids, but we can modify what the fish is made of by what we feed it. So we're also, though, at the same time feeling pressure not to use marine fish products, which are the main source of omega-3s. So we started looking at other healthy fatty acids like conjugated linoleic acids, and those can be worked into traditional oils like soybean oil. They can be chemically modified so that they'll have more of the healthy fatty acid. Then we feed these, we combine these lipids with the catfish diet and feed it to the fish for a certain period of time, and the fish will incorporate those healthy fatty acids into their tissue. So then we can advertise them as healthier fish.